Once you download the app, so you need to create Samsung account. So follow the instruction on screen to create an account and to complete the setup. So once you have logged in, so click on add devices. So there is a plus button where you can add, and this is the screen you get. Select the devices and then scroll down, and there is an option for camera. So once you select the camera, so select smart things. So once you select the smart things, you get this option as cam. So select that, and then you get a pop-up where you have to turn on the locations. So go to that location and select as always. For this app, right, you have to select as always. Once you have set the locations, so you need to scan the QR code. To scan the QR code, you need to remove the mounting plate. To remove the mounting plate, you need to press down and push forward. So if you see this, so this is how you need to remove the mounting plate. So you will get an option to connect your local Wi-Fi. So connect your local Wi-Fi and just continue the instruction on the screen to successfully set up your camera. So once you have successfully completed the setup, you get an option to set up two-step authentication. So if you are interested, you can provide your phone number and you can complete the setup. So once you are done with the setup, so this will be the first screen you will see on the app. Scroll down and there you will see your camera. You can click on it and you can see all the details. So once you have successfully added your security camera to SmartThings app, so when you open the app, so this is the screen you will see. Just scroll down and this is the camera which I have added. So click on that and okay, so this is the screen you will see and all the details of that camera. And here you will get an option where you can turn off the camera. So where I'm turning off, and you can turn on the camera, and whatever you are seeing the screen here, right? So this is the live video coming from the camera. And here below you will see all the history, if there are any captures or motion detected, right? So you will see all the details here. So next, let's see what are the settings option we have. So when you click on these three dots, right? So you will get all these options. So where you can see my info, edit and settings. So let's go to settings. It takes some time to come up. Yeah, once you get all these setting details, right? So these are the different settings you have for your camera and you can set as needed. So let's go one by one. First one is live view resolution. So I've given FSD and you can change it. And HDR is on, and night vision I've given as auto. So if your room is very wide, so you can select that. And next is watermark. So in your video, right? When you download that video, you will have a watermark with the SmartThings logo. So if you want, you can turn off that. Next is motion detection zone. So here you will get an option where you can select part of your room. So where if there is any motion or sound, so it can record the video. So here, right? So where if you see here, like where whatever the part of your room you want, right, you can select it. But for me, right, like I wanted everything to be selected. I'm like, if there is any motion in any part of that room, right, I wanted to capture, so I selected everything. So next is record automatically. So here if you want to capture a video, if there is a motion detection or sound detected, right, I have enabled both. Even you, if you want both, you can select both, or whatever option you need, you can select it. And if you can scroll down, and there is audio sensitivity, I've given medium. And next is recording time. So when there is a motion detected or sound detected, right? So where you, like how many seconds you want to capture the video. So currently I've given 10 seconds, so you can change it. And yeah, audio recording. And the status light is on, and these are the different options you get for your camera. Okay, let's see how you can schedule your camera, right? So when I say schedule, so where you can where you can turn on your camera on a specific time and you can turn off your camera on specific time. So where here they call as automation. So first thing, right, you have to click on this bar, three bars, and there you have an option for automations. Click on that, and here, right, so this is where you can set up that schedule. So click on this plus button. So first thing is, if add condition, so when you click and add condition, right, so there are different options here, but let's take time, right? So when you give time, if you want a specific time, so where, like, maybe you can say, so evening, maybe 6 o'clock, so 6 o'clock, and all days, like if you see repeat every day, so you can select, and when it's selected, right, it comes in a circle. So here you have different options if you want to turn on in a sunrise or sunset. So let's take a time now. So now I am giving 6 p.m. so click on save. So when you click on save, so add an action now. So at 6 p.m. what should happen, right? So click on add action. So then you can control your device. So what device you want to control, select my camera, click on save. So when you click on save, so at 6 p.m. what you want to do, you want to turn on your camera or turn off your camera. So let's say turn on, so click on save. So now at 6 p.m. every day, so your camera will turn on. So that is what we have created, an automation. Click on save, complete, and you can give a name. So every day 6 p.m. and you can say on. So maybe you can give iPhone on, so that you know at 6 p.m. and if you see, so now it is added to your automations. So let's do for same for off. So click on same, add condition, give time, and let's do morning 7 o'clock, 7 a.m. right, every day. Click on save. I want to turn off my camera. Click on go to off, turn off. Click on save. So now every day morning 7 a.m. so my security camera will turn off. Click on complete, give the name as off, 7 a.m. okay. So now we created an automation or a schedule where this camera, right, it will turn on every day evening 6 p.m. and it will turn off every day morning 7 a.m. so you can, there are like a lot of other options, you can check on that. So this is all about how you can schedule your camera.